In today's class, we are going to be discussing how to create a quick bill invoice. So first, we're going to navigate to accounts receivable. We're going to show you a couple of different entry screens for a reason. So this first one is going to be if you want to invoice a customer and not have to or want to code it to a job or an item, okay? So I'm going to show you the screen here. So once we get into the invoices screen, we're going to hit add. So if I just want to invoice a customer, pick them here. Obviously change your date if you want. Terms will default in. We have terms set up on the customer level normally, okay? So let's just say I want to just hit some miscellaneous account. And I just want to charge this person $2,500. And maybe it's they're reimbursing the company for something, or it's just a miscellaneous charge. And it doesn't need to go to a job, doesn't need to be tracked like as an item on the item level. So on this kind of level. So if you want to just do a simple bill to a customer, which would debit AR, credit revenue, and only hit the customer dimension, this is the screen you would use, okay? So miscellaneous service or something. And you just hit post. Need to put the location in. That was my fault there. Okay, so strange, but not all fields have a star. Most of them do, but location, if you have that on as a required dimension, you do need to fill that in. Post. And there's our invoice. Okay, so I'm going to go back in and show you how to view it and see what the effect of the GL is. Okay, so we're going to debit, AR trade, credit, revenue, other is what I set when I did the transaction posting here. Transaction coding. Okay. So you can use the screen as well to code to a job if you'd like. But there is another screen I'll show you in the order entry area that has some more fields available, or if you would rather use the order entry area. But notice I was able to come in here after I posted it, and I'm able to edit it based on my settings. So now you can see that it changed. So just FYI there. Okay. So let's say when you use this order entry area, you can come in here to quick bill invoices. We're going to add one. Just pick customer here. Then you can code it to a job. You don't have to, it's not required there. Okay, not required down here in the coding line. But on this screen, you do have to pick an item. Okay. So you could set up, you know, I guess a miscellaneous revenue item, but as these are all cost items, I'm just gonna pick one so we can show you the functionality, but you could set a revenue. Miscellaneous revenue one up, or miscellaneous service, or whatever you're doing or calling the stuff, and map that item to an account, a GL account. Okay. So I'm just wanting the bill for $300 or something. Okay. So up here. So do we have a location? Check that. And we're going to hit post. And now that is in there. Okay. So notice this is not changeable. You have to reverse it or and fix it through a reversal. On the other screen, we could edit. So just FYI difference there. So those are two ways to enter in quick bills in Intacct.